You are welcome to the Messiah Revelation channel, which is a prophetic end time ministry. We are preparing for God's final judgment. We are preparing for the arrival of the Messiah. And today we are continuing our series on judgment, part two of our series on judgment. We are focusing on God's final judgment procedures. In part one, we talk about judgment in general. Here we are talking about God's final judgment. When I say God's final judgment, I'm talking about the judgment that will be the last judgment in the world, and it will be like a judgment that we see in the courtroom. And this is what I mean by God's final judgment, the judgment of all judgments. It will come, and it will be the judgment that will determine who goes to the lake of fire and who also stays in the presence of the Lord. This is the final judgment. There will be a judgment on nations, but that is not the judgment I'm talking about. I'm talking about judgment of individuals, individual souls, the descendants of Adam, the final judgment that will come. And we are looking at the judgment. We are asking some questions. Who will be the judge? That will be the judge of all judges. And we can look at the book of John. Let's look at the book of John. John chapter 5, verse 22. John chapter 5, verse 22. For the Father judges no man, but has committed all judgment unto the Son. And so that is the first thing we need to know, who will be the judge. And the answer is found in the book of John chapter 5, verse 22. For the Father judges no man, but has committed all judgment unto the Son. The Son is Yeshua, Messiah. Elohim has given judgment to the Son. So Yeshua, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, will be the judge in the final judgment. And the scripture is in John chapter 5, verse 22. And since we are in John, we can also look at John 5, 27. And have given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of Man. So John 5, 27 is interesting. In the ordinary legal system that we are used to in the world, the judge judges, but he does not execute judgment. When the judge finishes the sentences, the other branch, they make sure that the person who is convicted is sent to jail. It is not the job of the judge to send somebody to jail. He commits somebody to jail, and then the system will commit that person to jail. In the final judgment, as we read in John chapter 5, verse 22, the Lord has given all judgment to the Son, Yeshua, Messiah, and he also will execute judgment. So after the final judgment, the Lord will instruct his angels to put people in the lake of fire. In the case of the Antichrist and the false prophet, and as we see in Revelation chapter 19, verse 20, and they will be cast directly into the lake of fire. And so for the false prophets and the Antichrist, that will be their final judgment. And as you see in the book of Revelation, there will also be a final judgment on Satan, where Satan, the father of the Antichrist, the father of the Freemason, he will also be cast into the lake of fire. So we are going on. Jesus, the Messiah, is the judge based on John 5:22. And what will be the basis of the final judgment? And here we can advise ourselves by going to Romans 2:16. The Lord will judge the secrets of men. And we should be warned that whatever we are doing, the records are there, records are kept. CCTV cameras are all in all places, in hotel rooms, in your bedroom, on the streets, anywhere, in your hearts, in your brains. So the thing that you imagine in your head, the thoughts that go on in your head, the words that come from your mouth, the things that you see with your eyes, what you decide with your heart, what you do, your deeds, your records, they will be the basis of judgment, and they will be recorded. And so who will be judged and who will not be judged? And the scripture is very clear. Nobody is spared of judgment, including the saints and sinners. Everybody will be judged. But the standards will be different from those who are the saints and those who are sinners. Definitely, the saints and the righteous people are not going to hell. They will be in the presence of the Lord, but we will still account for what we did while we are on earth. And that's why you need to keep the fight to the end. You need to overcome. Nobody will be spared of God's judgment. It's not like the presidential judgment in America, where an American president will plead presidential immunity, immunity from persecution, immunity from prosecution, immunity from judgment. It will not be like that. There will be no immunity from prosecution. Nobody will be spared. And the procedures of judgment will be supernatural. In the ordinary sense, somebody can run away from the jurisdiction where he's tried. He's in Texas or he's in Canada. The trial is going on. He moves out of the state and he's outside the jurisdiction. And if he's not apprehended, that's it. Some people escape judgment and they run to other countries. The final judgment is different. God's final judgment is different because there will be supernatural procedures. And through the supernatural procedures, everybody will be brought before the throne of the Most High, no immunity. And so let's look at the supernatural procedures by looking at the book of Revelation chapter 20, reading from verse 13. Revelation 20, verse 11 starts the judgment of the dead. Those who will be dead, they will be judged. Everybody will be judged. And we are looking at supernatural procedures in Revelation 20, verse 13. And the sea gave up the dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them. And they were judged, every man according to their works. According to their works. It means that in the day of God's final judgment, the sea will be instructed to give up the dead in the sea, and those who are in the sea. It includes, unfortunately, the Hebrews Israelites who were thrown into the sea by the slave masters. They were cast into the sea during the transatlantic slave trade. So many people are thrown into the sea. They get drowned in the sea. Ships sink in the sea. So many people are lost in the sea. Supernatural procedures will kick in during the final judgment because the sea will be asked to deliver everybody that is in the sea. And that will include the Pharaoh and his soldiers who pursued the Israelites when they were fleeing from captivity. And in Egypt, they were drowned in the Red Sea, in the sea. In the final judgment, the Red Sea will be commanded to give up everybody who is in the sea. And death will be subpoenaed by God to give everybody up. Everybody who is being held by death will be brought before the throne. Everybody who is dead, including the big and the small, Michael Jackson, including Nelson Mandela, including Prophet T.B. Joshua, including the professor Henry Kissinger, a leading architect of the New World Order who just died during the final judgment, dead. Death will be commanded to give him up for God's final judgment. And we need to prepare before the throne of the Most High. And if you are going to a courtroom, you have to do research about the judge, the demeanor of the judge, and in some cases even the prejudices of the judge. In America, some judges are racist. And so if you're appearing before a judge who is racist, you need to know how to comport yourself. Some judges are sexist, and some judges are liberal, some judges are lenient, some judges are wicked. So you need to know you are judge. In the United States, if you are going to a courtroom and the judge is racist, you need to prepare the client, particularly a black client, and going to face a judge, a white judge who is racist. You need to prepare your client how to talk, how to dress. In the same way, we need to prepare how to enter the throne room of God. The Lord is holy, and we have to be holy. You have to live a holy life without sin, without any wrinkles, without spot. Our garments must be spotless, without any wrinkles. We need to know how to prepare before the judgment throne, before entering the judgment throne of God. And you know the judge. Our judge is merciful, but on that day there will be no mercy. The period of grace will have expired. The Lord has already prepared his throne for judgment, and the throne was prepared before the foundations of the earth. And the records are set. And on the day of judgment, the judgment will be by opening of books. So let's look at Revelation 20, verse 11. And I saw a great white throne and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, and there were found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were opened, and another book was opened. So Revelation 20, verse 12 is talking about books. Multiple books were opened, and another book was opened. Another book, which is the book of life. And so books will be opened. And the one special book will be opened. That is the book of life. The book of life belonging to the Lamb of God, Yeshua Messiah. And you should not be wondering why is it that there's a book of life belonging to the Messiah, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. It's because he's the Son of God, Elohim. He died for our sins, and salvation belongs to God and also to the Lamb of God. If you read Revelation chapter 7, verse 10. And so there's a book of life, and everybody whose name is found not written in the book of life will be cast into the lake of fire. So you need to remember, or all of us need to remember, that books will be opened. It presupposes that the Lord is taking records of whatever we do, including the things that are done in secret. And I emphasize secret because in public, many people behave. They don't commit sin in public. They don't want people to know what they are. What is wrong with them, so they comport themselves in public, but in private, so many things go on in secret. That's why Romans 2:16 says, God will judge the secrets of man based upon the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that's the final judgment. There will be a witness, and the faithful witness will be there. The Lion of the tribe of Judah is a faithful witness. On that day, he will testify that he was sent to the world to die for the sins of the world. And he preached the gospel of salvation to them. And his prophets preached the gospel of salvation and judgment to the world. And so he will testify. And in the days of Moses, two witnesses were enough. Three witnesses were enough. And the days of the final judgment, you don't need two witnesses. You don't need three. The Lion of the tribe of Judah, the faithful witness, his witness will be enough for final conviction, final judgment. Of course, apart from Yeshua, God himself will be there as a witness. His eyes are watching the earth from north to south, from east to west, day and night. He doesn't sleep, he doesn't slumber, and he will see everything that we do. And so God himself will be a witness. But even if God doesn't become a witness, and Yeshua doesn't become a witness on that day, the stones and the trees and the flowers and the hotel rooms and the gay bars, they will come and testify about the sins that we committed. The gay flags will come and they will come to testify and identify those who held the gay flags in the church, in the embassies, on the streets, those who rebelled against God. Stones will come to testify if they are called to testify. And on that day, there will be final separation, and those who will have the opportunity to be in the presence of the Lord for eternity, and those who will be cast into the lake of fire. You have to remember that there's a major principle of judgment. It is found in Hebrews 9:27. Hebrews 9:27 is very, very important. It's one of the major scriptures on judgment. And it states, it is appointed unto man to die once, and after that, judgment. Hebrews 9:27, the major scripture on judgment. And it is appointed unto man once to die, but after this, the judgment. And if you read Hebrews 9:28, so Christ was once offered to hear the sins of many, and unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation. So 2 days are important. The day of death, that's when judgment begins, because on the day of death, after death, immediately after death, the separation will begin, and those who will go and wait for the final judgment, separation will be done. Separation will begin. The sinful will not mingle with the righteous on death, and all of them, they will be raised on the last day for the final judgment. But for those who die in the Lord, they will be in the presence of the Lord. There will be reward, and they will go through the judgment of the Lord. But the wrath of God will not be poured on them. But those who did not repent, they will go through the judgment of God. And finally, they will be separated from the presence of God, and they will be cast into the lake of fire. There's a salvation plan, and the plan is to believe in the Messiah, John 3:16, and repent from our sins. James is telling us that it's important for us to have faith in the Messiah, but faith without work is not good faith. And so when we look at Revelation 20 verse 13, is written, and the sea gave up their dead which were in it, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them, and they were judged every man according to their works. So works is very, very important. According to their works, good works, works that promote the kingdom, and works relating to your separation from sin. So if anybody tells you that work is not important, the person is preaching doctrines of demons. And in America, they preach doctrines of demons. They say that all that you have to do is to have faith in Christ. That's it. You don't even have to repent. And so T.D. Jakes is saying that you don't have to repent because the blood of Christ is sufficient to cover all sins. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to do any work. No work is needed. But as we read from Revelation 20:13, the sea gave up the dead, hell gave up the dead, and death gave up the dead, and they were judged based upon what was written in the books based upon their works. So the Lord will ask you your work. The Lord will ask you your faith. And the Lord will be looking at the records of your repentance. Did you repent from the sins? And did you obey the commandments of the Most High? If you fear God, if you believe in the Messiah, you will run away from sin. And sin will not be part of you because you believe in the Messiah. And Philippians 2:12 is very, very important. Work for your own salvation with fear and trembling. And as you know from the scriptures, Stephen, Paul, Isaiah, and the prophets, they work for their salvation with fear and trembling. And they did not even fear death because they found themselves to be honored to die for the gospel, because they were looking for a better resurrection. And so for those who die, death will not have any control over you if you die in Christ, because it's written in Revelation 14 verse 13, blessed are those who died in Christ, and they will rest from their labor, and their works will follow them. And this is encouraging news for us as we prepare for the final judgment that is coming. If you die, that's it. We have probation period until the day of death. If there's death today, there will be no repentance tomorrow and no salvation tomorrow. And all that we have to do is to wait for the final day of judgment. The day of judgment is coming. It's appointed unto man to die once after that judgment. But that is not the final judgment. The final judgment will come when the Lord will sit on his throne and the books and a book will be opened. The different books of records. And then the angels will be going through the book of life. And the Bible is very clear in Revelation 20:15, and those whose names were not found written in the book were cast into the lake of fire. I thank you for watching this video. Thank you.